Hey guys, it's Mike here, one go short play. Hey, Bubsy, there's a Bubsy Bobcat. In Close Encounters of the Third Kind. I see what they're doing. Close Encounters of the Third Kind. There you go, only took three goes. Bubsy, if I remember right, in fact, I've got to know this now. Let's reset it. Now, just doing a soft reset. Emulator. I'm sure a friend of mine and a former colleague did some of the graphics on this. Now, if there's a way to get to the credits. Ah. There isn't, is there? Full audio, passcode. Oh, yeah, creators. No, maybe not. Produced by, design. No, he's none of those. Oh well, I'm sure he told me he did work on this. Maybe it was Bubsy 2. In particular, those little islands in the background, I remember seeing something about. Anyway, in a piece on pixel art. It wasn't very nice about them. Yeah, a friend of mine said he did them. I thought he did. Now, I've never played the game. Oh, and I have to be honest, I'm not particularly liking the way it plays at the moment. But first, very, very first impressions. Oh, you know what it feels like? What was that game? You know. The one with the multi aardvark or whatever it was. That I really hated. Does anyone remember what it was called? I know you're not in the room with me, so you can't tell me. Oh, what was it called? It's in this Mega Drive list somewhere. Go and have a look. It begins with A, I know that much. And it was terrible to play. This is pretty bad too. Right, sorry about that. I just paused the video again because my other half, my partner Joe, just brought me a cup of coffee. Which is really nice. One of the advantages of working from home is that when I'm on a little break, I get a little cups of tea brought to me by my girlfriend Jo. Isn't that nice of her? She doesn't have to do that. She's just there. She's just nice like that. Right. This is awful, as I was saying. This is pretty rough. Now, interesting scrolling. I noticed the scrolling does that. See the way the scrolling put me at the back of the screen? Just when I was going right, not when I'm going left. There. It's as if, almost as if it's saying, yeah, we messed up the speed of this game, so we can't stick you in the middle of the screen. So we're gonna give you an advantage by moving the screen for you, just for that bit. Oh, it's really rough. It's like that other game. It's almost as though it's built on the same engine. In fact, the character does all that talking that other character does, like that. And I've got a feeling this is the same engine. And why do you keep reusing it? I don't know. That's quite cute. Okay. Oh, I hit a banana. It's bad. It's bad game. You know what? My instincts when I was a kid were against getting involved with this game. And I'm kind of glad that I went with those instincts. This ain't no Booger Man. This certainly ain't no Sonic. You know, but it makes me wonder sometimes. Maybe this was a decent game, and then Sonic came along. I'm sure this is more recent than Sonic, though. But I sometimes think with these games, maybe these are decent games, and then Sonic came along and blew them all out of the water. And, you know, up to that point, they were good, maybe. Maybe that's the case. I don't know. It feels like this was a bad copy of Sonic, like that other game. This is bad. This is bad, boys and girls. I'm not impressed with this at all. It's hard to explain just how unresponsive this game is. I'm not going to go shouting about it and get all irate like I did last time. What happened there? I don't even know how I died. Is that meant to kill you, that thing? Well, you know, we were playing Bubba and Sticks just before the Christmas holidays, and how slick that was. I feel there's a frame rate issue going on here. It's a little bit jumpy and jerky. Now, I'm going to blame the emulator for any pauses we might see. Can I get on that? Or would I have to jump in there? There's like a delay when you hit the button to move in, which is fine, you see that in the likes of Sonic, but there's like a really bad drag. Oh no, really? That was death. After all that effort to get in there, that was death. Death. Right, we live and learn, but I'm not very impressed with the lesson. It's very hard to be accurate. Do you see what I mean? That just killed me. That was a fall, based on the fact that I couldn't stop when I was running down that hill. Right. Actually, it was based on the fact that I couldn't jump accurately enough. Oh, really? To land on that? This sucks. I mean, I can see how the physics is kind of right there. That was a long fall. But I don't really expect it to kill me. I'm a cartoon bobcat. You know, I remember this game being quite... Not good, by any means, because I don't know, because I never played it. I remember it being popular, despite my instinct saying, I don't bother. As a kid, you know, 40 quid game and all that. Hey, that's what I wanted to do. It does feel really, really rough. I mean, really rough. Oh, that totally threw me. That face you pulled. It just... it literally stopped my gameplay. I want to do that again. Oh, see you can. I like the music. The music cues are good. I'm stuck in an endless cycle. That's how long this music is on for. That long. Okay, we're done. You hit the boot and it throws you back up there. None of it makes sense. I like the fact that there's lots of animations. You know, that's charming, isn't it? And he lands and he's all wet and he shakes himself off. That's kind of cool. Lack of warning. See, I know I'm talking about Sonic again. You say it's the fastest. I'm not dying to Sonic, by the way. Whenever I see a bad platformer, I have to kind of make the comparison because I can see what's so good about Sonic now. Ah, that's icy. There, trains coming at you. Like, well, we know. Maybe that's Sonic. it's a bit sucky. Now, see, I think the likes, and I'll go back to it. Oh, what? I think the likes of Sonic the Hedgehog wasn't as fast as this. Not by a long shot. It was just made to look as fast as this. The whole thing where you actually have quite a slow, steady movement, but a fast running run animation, that's usually the best way to create the illusion of sort of speed. Now, see the way this character's got that walk animation there. It doesn't actually run very fast. If it was Sonic, the animation would speed up faster to a fast run while he was still moving at a rate that you could manage, you know. And but the illusion of speed really kind of came from the slowdown at the end of the run. So you'd be running and the very fast animation would be going down and then you'd let go. And he'd slow to a stop, but it'd be a very predictable rate, the slowdown, you know. Oh, you swine right in the head. I was trying really hard to avoid that. And what it made for was a very controllable character. It wasn't really as fast as the game was making out he was. And what we've got here is something that jumps frames, runs animations a bit too slow to be convincing, runs himself around the screen too fast to be accurate, and has a kind of an unpredictability in when he moves and stops. I'd have to spend a bit of time with Bubsy here to figure out exactly what's up with him. I don't think I can be bothered, to be blunt. But it's not Sonic. See the way there's no slowdown and he was moving to kind of stop suddenly. Well, there's one now, I've said that. In fact, no, it didn't, he just carried on moving. But see, when he stops, it's like, there's no decremental integers going on. It doesn't count as speed down. It just kind of runs at set speed, stops. And then maybe when you hit an incline, he walks automatically at set speed and stops. And it makes for a very, very jagged gameplay experience. I think I've used that word a few times before, and I'm starting to... it's starting to have a meaning to me. I don't like the fact that you can't fall very far either. Oh, I've had enough. Oh, thank goodness for that. Yeah, that's Bubsy. It's as bad as it looks. Thanks for watching.